Let's do it. Let's climb your stupid tower.
Oh, I'm so excited!
Fall is a basic thriller about two women who are stranded after they climb a dilapidated radio tower. It's a straightforward survival story, but one that works thanks to solid filmmaking and the vertigo-inducing camera work.
Who wants to play Bodies, Bodies, Bodies?
So how do you play?
Bodies, Bodies, Bodies is a slasher flick that rises above genre limitations with nice acting and a very witty screenplay. It's a horror comedy and another nice surprise from film distributor A24.
I laid down in that pod, and when I came out, I was in this body!
Mack and Rita, on the other hand, is a dud of a body switch comedy. It's the story of a young woman who is magically transformed into an energetic older woman. Diane Keaton has fun playing the glamorous grandma role, but these are minor moments at best.
Vampire hunting is a business.
Jamie Foxx stars as a blue-collar vampire killer in Day Shift. Now, I didn't get the chance to see this one, but Foxx, Snoop Dogg, Megan Good, and Dave Franco make it look like some horror comic fun.
What is there to do around here?
Not much. If my party is awful, I'll never live it down.
And finally, 13 the Musical, based on the Broadway play, is a story about a New York kid who is suddenly uprooted to Indiana. He plans to win new friends by throwing the biggest bar mitzvah party ever. This is definitely aimed at middle school kids, but Jason Robert Brown's music might appeal to some of the adults.
What just happened?
Middle school.
And that's what's new this week at the movies. I'm Sean McBride, the movie guy.
Five movies.
Well, we do have movies, but I do want to qualify this by saying while we have movies, it does not necessarily mean quality movies.
That's right.
That's why Sean's here, so that we can ferret out the good from the bad, the yeses and the noes.
It's a very mixed bag of a week.
Is it really?
And I expect that that's going to be the case for the next couple of months here. If their films were really big and had lots of opportunity to make money, they would have been released in the summer when the kids are out of school, and now there's just really no blockbusters. It's interesting, though, because some films, like, for example, Mrs. Harris Goes to Paris, and people miss that. Well, it's back in theaters.
My memory. Who's in that particular
Leslie
movie?
Leslie Manville. She's a woman who wants to buy a couture dress, and it's just a sweet little British thing. Right. And it was here and then gone, and well, it's coming back. And so some of those movies you may have missed, you may get another chance for that. There are some okay films this week, though. So I would say that there's a pretty good thriller. A better than average.
He's already walking it back.
I know,
okay,
exactly,
maybe so. It's not good.
Look, this is a film called Fall. And it's a story about these two women, and one of them's traumatized. They're extreme mountain climbers. And she lost her boyfriend from an accident there. So she doesn't want to get back on the mountain here. Well, she's got a friend who says, hey, there's an old dilapidated radio tower in the middle of the desert. Let's go climb this thing. And so they do, trying to get her spirit and her energy back up. Right. And of course, it's dilapidated. It's fallen apart. They get stranded on top of this 2,000-foot tower in the middle of nowhere. Nobody knows where they are. Their cell phones don't work. How do they survive? And this is a very basic thing, but it's a man versus nature, a woman versus gravity story here. And because of the cinematography and the vertigo of it, I think it works. I mean, there's a certain lizard brain reaction to some of
this. I was going to say, this is one of those movies I'm not sure I could sit through. It's not one of my favorite things is height. And when you're looking off the edge, and I can see just from the trailer that they're playing on that big time.
And that is very worth it. There's a visceral thrill to this that I think works very well. Yeah. I don't think it's a great thriller, but it's fine and it
theaters
does its
only?
Job. Theaters only.
Okay.
Right, so the other one that's in theaters only but only at the Tinseltown this week is a good film called Bodies, Bodies, Bodies. And it's a story of a bunch of rich kids. They gather for a hurricane party, storms approaching, they go to a mansion. They're planning on just having a drug-fueled weekend. And they decide to play this game that I've always heard is mafia, but you close your eyes, who's the killer? It's a party game, but someone actually ends up getting killed. And this turns into a slasher movie, and there's nothing special about that. It's an Agatha Christie type murder mystery. Who's the killer, blah, 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 who's next? But I think the thing that makes this better than normal is the screenplay. It's so witty and cutting. These rich, woke kids, it's all Gen Z and performative social consciousness. It's I think it's really kind of fun and funny. It's a horror comedy.
Okay. Both of those coming at you. Don't go thinking it's only, because purists might have a problem.
Yeah.
Oh, it's not a horror movie.
No, a horror comedy.
Okay.
Exactly.
Gotcha. All right. So what's left?
You have Mack and Rita, which is a Diane Keaton movie.
I saw
movie,
that one, yeah.
And I think this is the worst movie of the week, quite frankly. So although the Netflix ones didn't really scream. But she's a woman, a young woman who goes to this new agey thing. She lies down in a thing and she wakes up as Diane Keaton. And now she's supposed to find her love for life by being a glamour granny, as she calls herself. It's Diane Keaton and her girlfriends making a comedy. I just didn't find it funny. I didn't really like this one at all. So this is in theaters also. Then over on Netflix, we have two films, and neither of which screened for critics, but I woke up in the middle of the night, so I've seen about an hour of each of them, so I can tell you that. The first one is Day Shift. It's Jamie Foxx, it's Snoop Dogg, it's Megan
Good. Oh, that's the vampire thing.
He's a struggling father. You know, ostensibly he's running a pool cleaning business, but really he's hunting vampires. And he's trying to survive, make enough money to keep his wife and his daughter from moving across the country. It's an action film.
Extreme violence, obviously.
Yeah, exactly. A lot of blood and stuff. It opens with this senior scene right here. And I thought it was pretty well done, but like I say, I only saw the first.
All right, so what other hour did you see?
And then the other one was 13 the Musical, which is a Broadway musical turned into a play. This was not a hugely successful Broadway musical. It is, it's about a middle schooler. He moves from New York to Indiana, and now he's complaining. There's nothing to do here, and how am I going to do my bar mitzvah? And it's about middle schooler ages. Okay. All the girls worry about my first kiss and blah, blah, blah. It's notable for Jason Robert Brown, who is the composer of the music, who is a very big-time Broadway composer. This was one of his first shows. I don't think this is a great movie.
And, you know, to me, this week kind of speaks also to that idea that, you know, production of content is so prolific now. There's so much coming out because there are so many options and so many different channels. They're not all going to be hits. You're going to have a lot of things that are going to appeal to a very narrow audience.
And it's interesting. This past couple of weeks, we've had both Netflix and HBO who got into trouble by saying, no, we just want content, anything. Just throw it against the wall.
Right.
Who knows what's going to happen? And they've been kind of walking it back, HBO in particular, saying, no, we still want quality, not quantity, because Netflix has had troubles with getting people to come to them. So it's kind of fascinating that I think the pendulum is swinging back to let's try and make some good stuff, maybe not so much, because there's a lot of...
The other thing that I would note real quickly is the fact that we are seeing so much more international influence on the streaming channels. Where at one time you would have only seen American-made product. Now you might have a German-made movie that you have a choice. You can either subtitle or you can watch
the dub it. Or they say, well, that was really good. Let's remake that in English.
Right.
And that works
true,
too.
So
it's always... always do the subtitles, folks. some of that voice acting is sometimes very bad.
It can be pretty cheesy. You're right about that. All right. 38 past the hour. Don't forget, Sean drops by every Friday to talk about what's new at the box office and streaming. Thank you, Sean.